Hey witches, welcome back to the channel once again. This is Hectarios, Witch of the Realms. For today's video, we're going to do our reading for the full moon on February 16th. We have Valentine's Day, Lupercalia, and the full moon back to back. This reading is basically going to cover all of these energies that are at play at the beginning of this week. So let's talk about what I'm feeling psychically with this energy. I really feel almost this sort of need to do protection and protective work. I've also been feeling a lot of sexual energy, and it makes sense because we're heading into spring in the Northern Hemisphere. And so a lot of renewal of energies, of just vitality in general. Yesterday and the day before, I was up for like 36 hours just with energy. I don't know what came over me, but I was just awake. Again, thinking about springtime and mating season, heading into spring and then to summer. Definitely have been feeling a lot of sexual energy with that coming to the surface. And a lot of just, once again, just revitalization in general. Also, I'm feeling messages to do with sort of your appearance. Obviously, I'm a fairy elf today, but I have been feeling that energy as well. Things like maybe to do with makeovers or glamorizing yourself in some way, getting fit, dieting, anything to do with your appearance, right? Because I'm going to segue into the astrology section. 16th, and this full moon is right there in Leo. Okay, so Leo is that energy of fame, like your ego, your appearance, your image, the way that you present to others, the way that other people see you. Leo is ruled by the sun, so it's sort of that projecting, masculine, assertive energy of like, I'm here, this is me, this is my expression of myself. That type of energy. So that's, I feel, a large part of the energy that I've been feeling, like, once again, of doing like makeovers or glamorizing yourself, getting fit, dieting, also fashion, updating your wardrobe, anything like that, basically, that has to do with your appearance and how you express yourself through your appearance. That has largely been what I've been picking up on psychically over the last several days. One thing I did notice that was kind of odd, the sun is in Aquarius, so is Jupiter and Neptune. And then we have all these other planets just right here on this side of the sky. The full moon in Leo and opposite side of the sky, pretty much all the other planets stacked together. I mean, look at this, that's crazy. So there could be that sort of feeling of opposition at this time with this as well, which is calling back to where I said I was feeling like this energy of doing protection work. That could be something, maybe there could be some situation where you're feeling like you're the odd one out or something like that, just opposing energy, whether that is malicious or otherwise, could just be some way, like, type of way that you're feeling. But there is this sort of energy like that, dynamic, opposing energy. So I feel like this would be a good time to just do protective work as well with that. Now, I do want to mention about Lupercalia. So this is a Roman feast day or festival day. This was an ancient ritual of purification through animal sacrifice. And there was also people partnering with certain partners or random partners and coupling and stuff like that. So it was very much of a sexual energy and rite as well. But it was used to purify the city and the fields and the people and to lead the way into good health and fertility for the next season. In fact, the month of February is named after a certain tool that they use during this ritual, a purification tool. So there is an energy of purification, I feel, protection once again, because it's an energy of like ensuring good health and fertility and good fortune, basically, as well. I even had a dream recently that a voodoo priestess gave me a sage smudge stick and was telling me to do sage and cleansing. And I haven't really done that through the whole house in quite a while. So I'm probably going to be doing that on this Lupercalia on the 15th. But definitely there's that sort of energy that I feel like needs to be inserted into this reading, into this video. So that would be my advice to you as well. Do some more major, deeper cleansing of your space, spiritually speaking. That could go a long way as far as purifying and setting the stage for blessings to come in. So that's my advice on that. I also earlier was having thoughts of doing a spiritual bath for Valentine's Day. So that's something that you might want to do as well. You can do some kind of attraction spell or just beautification, once again, like I was saying, to sort of just help you with whatever it is that you might want to do at this time. So those are my ideas and thoughts and sort of psychic insights that I've been getting lately. And we're going to go ahead and get into the cards now, see what they have to say. Now I align myself with the Most High God and the Holy Spirit, Hecate. Please communicate the truth to me through these cards so that I may be guided for the highest good of all. Thank you and so may it be. Please give us your divine guidance for this Valentine's Day, Lupercalia, and the full moon. What do we need to know or do for our highest good of all? What are the energies surrounding us now? Please give us your divine insight and guidance. Thank you, and so let it be. That energy was strong. Almost gave me a shiver. Okay, let's see what we have. Okay, so the first card that we have is the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is someone who has been through a lot in their life, and so they're sort of quick to become more aggressive or more assertive, more defensive of their self. Because of that, there is a warning with this card saying don't rush into battle, don't be too hasty, don't make rash decisions and choices with whatever situation's going on for you. You don't want to be too quick with your choices and the decisions that you're making, the actions that you're taking. You want to be a little bit more patient, a little bit more diligent, and deeply think about things, make plans. Also to just wait a while, because you never know if things are just gonna blow over on their own without you having to do something or possibly make it worse by rushing or jumping the gun and doing something that you make a mistake, right? That's the sort of warning with this card. However, the positive aspect of this card is an energy of ingenuity, creativity, thinking up new ways of doing things, but the more positive meant, right? The longer you think about something, the more creativity that you get, the more it becomes your own expression, or a deeper expression, the more that you meditate on your choices and on your decisions and on things that you're facing in your life, in your relationships, whatever, the deeper and longer that you think about it, the more that you're able to more deeply know your feelings about a situation or about a person or whatever, and thus you'll express yourself better as well. So think about that with this card. Also too, when certain situations come into our life, be it with another person or whatever, you know, certain things can make us become heated or upset or angry or scared or just whatever it is. And so once again with the Knight of Swords, it's like don't quickly make any decisions or choices based on your sort of initial reaction, right? You want to let it ruminate, think about it, give yourself time to calm down or just become more centered back into yourself before you then will make your choice and your decision and take your actions, which will most likely be a smarter approach, right? Because it's been more well thought out. So there's that whole energy with this Knight of Swords card. But once again, I don't want you to think it's only a sort of a negative card with the whole warning aspect. It is also a very powerful card of creative intellect and self-expression. It's very powerful energy. The next card that we have is the Five of Chalices. Well, let's just be realistic. This is a glass half full energy. Okay, there's a sense of almost loss, disappointment with something, with some situation, with some relationship, whatever, maybe even separation. This card has a lot to say about acceptance of the way things are, right? Really, the main message of this card is not dwelling in that sense of disappointment or loss or separation, whatever it is. This is a general reading, so it's going to be different for everyone. But if you find yourself facing a situation where you're disappointed or you feel a sense of loss or you separate from somebody or something that you'd rather not, this card brings a message of acceptance of the way that things are. There's no sense in dwelling on what you cannot change, what's already been done, things like that. It's better to just cherish what you have now, right? That's a pathway to healing from these darker emotions. Gratitude, thankfulness for what you have, what you did have, cherishing memories, right? And also the knowledge that nothing is permanent. Everything changes. You can have hope for the future. You know, more will come into your life and replace whatever has gone away. I mean, we're all human beings, right? If something happens that upsets you, if you lose someone, have some other major disappointment or loss in your life, you're gonna be upset. But don't stay that energy. Don't dwell there. Let your emotions come, let them pass. But know that there is hope. We see the bird here, sort of just flying and overlooking this whole situation. Grief and loss can feel like tidal waves of energy. It can feel like you're drowning. But there is a pathway to healing, whatever that is for you. And definitely just getting your mind off of it and focusing more on, you know, gratitude for what you have and cherishing things around you, the people around you now, can be a very good way to overcome these dark emotions. Your support, your family, your friends, things like that. Having just loving connections. And that's a good segue into the final card that we have, the Four of Pentacles. With this energy, it's sort of all about holding on tightly to what you have. In many ways, honestly, this card is about collecting your coin, right? It's a four, it's a foundational earth energy and building up your abundance, your finances, your resources, your relationships, putting in effort, putting in work. It's really all about making things stronger in that sense, building them up. So this could be another area where you start putting your focus in and working on yourself, working on your life, working on your other relationships, making things stronger, making yourself stronger, making your family stronger, making your friends stronger, right? All of that sort of building up energy. This card has a bad rap. Right, the Four of Pentacles, a lot of people say it's a card of greed, holding on too tightly to what you have, being sort of a Scrooge. But there's a lot to be said for the positive aspects of that energy. Sometimes it is what's needed. Sometimes you need to be a little bit more collected, a little bit more disciplined, a little bit more in control, and not give so much away, not give too much away. Maybe you've been in a situation where you're giving more than you're getting back, right? That's an appropriate time for you to use the Four of Coins energy. So think about that too. And another thing that comes to mind just by looking at the image here we see the woman has 3 coins here with her in her home. There's one more out here, almost like it's beckoning and calling to her. It also has sort of like a Rapunzel vibe with that. Maybe you're too sheltered. Maybe you are too comfortable and you really need to go out of your way to seek out this final coin. I don't think that this will apply to everyone, obviously, but I feel like some of you might be dealing with a breakup or a separation at this time, or maybe simply because it's Valentine's Day, you may be thinking of your lack of a relationship or one that you've lost in the past. Something like that could be at play here. Don't dwell too long in that energy and start, you know, just work on yourself with this. Once again, work on yourself, your other relationships. When I'm seeing these cards now, I feel like that does also harken back to what I said at the beginning of this, feeling that need for cleansing work. And the Lupercalia festival, feast day, also being about purification. That seems to be heavily what's needed with this energy as well. Do some major cleansing and purification and shedding whatever this darker energy is that's either within you or around you at this time. So I highly recommend, once again, do like a full spiritual cleansing of your entire house and your property. Then also do a cleansing of yourself with a spiritual bath. Things like that I feel could be very beneficial if you're dealing with these energies. Or even if you're not, it would still be a great time to do this because it is the Lupercalia Festival. And doing so will help lead you into a more prosperous energy and a more protected energy as well. And that's another thing too, with what I was talking about earlier, sort of working on yourself, beautification of your appearance, more if it's focused on diet and health and getting fit as well. Just anything, once again, like that could also be part of this working on yourself energy with this. Once again, if you're sort of in a bad energy, if you're in one of these situations where you're feeling that loss or disappointment, or you've just separated, or whatever this darker energy might be, doing a glow up of yourself when maybe you don't really feel like doing it, but do it anyways, will help you as well with that healing and help you move out of that energy. Try it and see. Doing cleansing, doing purification, doing cleaning, physical cleaning of your house or whatever as well. Any type of that cleaning, cleansing energy, you will always feel better afterwards. That's just how it is. Because you're getting rid of, you know, all of that dirtiness, whether that is physically or spiritually. Cleansing it out, you will always feel better afterwards. And doing any type of glow up or glamorizing, or just working on yourself, working on your appearance in any way, also you will feel much better afterwards too, because you're putting in that work on yourself. It doesn't really even matter if anyone else sees it, if anyone else notices. Just the fact that you're putting that work in on yourself and devoting that energy and time to yourself, self-love and self-care, it's going to make you feel better as well. So that is also something I wanted to add to this as well. It's also sort of a magical aspect and a magical trick to it as well. Doing something like this often, or just when you need it, can really be a very powerful pick-me-up, but it can also really charge your aura with attractive energy. And I don't just mean romantic attraction or physical attraction, but just attractive energy of good fortune and abundance too. In general, I think that's all that's coming through for this reading, though, guys. Hopefully, this helped you. It's not really what I was expecting, but here we are. And hopefully, you know, you're able to take what fits and apply it to your life, or take whatever advice I gave and apply it to your life where it fits. And I hope that you have a lovely Valentine's Day, a wonderful Lupercalia, and a magical full moon as well. But that's going to be all for this video. If you would like to get in touch with me for a private reading or for spell work, you can contact me through the methods below in the description box. And also, if you would like to join my Patreon and access all of my private video lessons and courses to do with magic and the occult, the more advanced things that I don't share publicly, you can go over to my Patreon as well and join up. If you're already part of my Patreon, thank you for joining. As always, until next time, hell hecate, hell to the witches, and blessed be.